Hi folks, Chef Jim here. Today we're going to teach you how to make a Romesco sauce. Romesco sauce is a Spanish roasted tomato and bell pepper sauce, and it goes great on any kind of white meat protein you use. Grilled chicken breast is great, pork chops is great, and it works especially well with fish. So let's get started. There are a couple steps to this. First step is getting your vegetables roasted. So first I have here 3 plump tomatoes, which I've taken the stems off in half. I have half of a small white onion, which has been quartered, and I have a half of a red bell pepper, which has been cut into cubes, and 3 cloves of garlic, which has been peeled, and the root ends have been taken off. I'm going to put all these into a small bowl. We're going to season with a little bit of salt and pepper. And we're going to add about 2 teaspoons of olive oil. You give it a little toss, just to make sure everything is coated with some oil on it, because that's going to help promote charring. And we're going to add that to a little roasting pan, which we're going to lightly spray with some non-stick cooking spray. Put all your ingredients in, and turn your tomatoes so that the flat side is down. Now this is all going to go into a preheated 375 degree oven for about 20 minutes. When the tomato skins start to char, we're going to take them out and we're going to take them off and put them back in for another 5 minutes. So we'll get these in the oven and we'll get back to it. All right, folks, the tomatoes have come out of the oven. You can see the skin is starting to blister and char a little bit. We're going to remove these skins because we don't want that in our sauce later on. And this should just pop right off with a pair of tongs or your fingers if you're a little more heat resistant than most. Slide right off. Okay, skins are off. This is going to go back in the oven for about another 5 more minutes just to kind of deepen the flavor a little bit more, and then we'll begin to make our sauce. Okay, we have our vegetables fresh out of the oven. They've actually been sitting here for a minute so I can handle the pan. They're cool. You can do this while they're hot, it's fine. You want to put your vegetables into some sort of tall and narrow container. We're going to be using an immersion blender. Whenever you use an immersion blender, you want something that's taller rather than wider. It blends much better. Everybody into the container. Okay. After this, we're going to add about 2 tablespoons of sherry vinegar. Have sherry vinegar, red vinegar is just fine, cider vinegar will work. About a teaspoon of oregano, a pinch of salt and pepper, and then we're going to blend. You can do this in a traditional blender as well. If your ingredients are hot though, make sure you don't have the lid on. Cover it with a towel, otherwise it will pop off and it'll mess all over. It won't be fun. Once everything is sort of emulsified, we're going to add about a half a cup of day-old bread that I've cubed and I've toasted and then I've cubed. Another traditional ingredient for Romesco sauce is almonds. I usually leave almonds out just for allergy purposes here at work. Once your bread's incorporated, go and drizzle in about a half cup of olive oil while the machine is running. Nice and smooth, give it a taste. up later in the house. I'm going to show you a quick application to use your Romesco sauce with. Over here on the stove, I have some vegetable stock. We're going to make some couscous. If you don't have vegetable stock, you can use chicken stock, or you can use just plain water, but if you're using water, please add a little salt to it, give it some flavor. Once you get your water to a boil or your stock, we're going to add our couscous. It's about a half cup for one serving. It's about a half cup of stock to a third cup of couscous. Turn off your heat. Put in your couscous. Give it a stir. And cover it. Leave that alone for about 5 minutes. Okay. Now we're going to make a little bit of quick sauteed shrimp. Over here I have some peeled and deveined 2125 shrimp. We have a little olive oil, chopped garlic, chopped parsley, Spanish paprika, and sherry wine. We're going to let our pan get nice and hot. Pan is hot, we're going to add probably about a tablespoon of olive oil, maybe a tablespoon and a half. We're going to add our shrimp. Your shrimp is in. We'll season with a little bit of salt and pepper. And about half a teaspoon of Spanish paprika. Pan is hot, otherwise the shrimp will release their juices and just kind of boil in them as opposed to getting any ice here on them. After you turn your shrimp, I'm going to put in some chopped garlic. However much you like is fine, that's probably about 2 teaspoons. About 3/4 cooked, maybe all the way cooked, close to all the way cooked. We're going to add our sherry wine. We're going to put the flame to burn off the alcohol and take it off the heat. That's where we're going to start our parsley. Give it a quick pause. That sherry is going to mostly evaporate. It's going to sort of glaze the shrimp food. If you wanted to, you could finish just with a little bit of butter, but I don't think that's really necessary. We're going to check our couscous. Looks good. So once your couscous is set, it takes 3 to 5 minutes. Couscous is really quick, it's really simple to cook. What we're going to do now is add a little bit more salt and pepper. A little bit of lemon juice, probably a teaspoon. And again, some chopped parsley. You can use cilantro, you can use basil, whatever you care for. I have parsley, so we're going to use that. Stir that in and kind of fluff it up with a fork. helps separate the grains of the couscous as opposed to a spoon, which will pack it a little bit. And now it's time to serve. Take our Romesco first. Put a dollop down on the plate, a little pile. Take off the excess. And with the back of your spoon, the tip, kind of run it in there, gradually increasing pressure. It's a common restaurant technique, gives you a little bit of a swipe, a swoosh kind of effect. Clean our plate up a little bit. Next, we'll add our couscous. Wanted to get fancy, you could pack this into a timbale or a teacup if you wanted. If you're going to use a teacup, you have to turn it out. Be very careful so you don't smash your teacup on your plate. And then we're going to put the shrimp in. Garnish, and we're all set. We have a quick Romesco sauce with sauteed shrimp and couscous. Hope you try it, and I hope you enjoy it.
Thanks.